Welcome back, YouTubes. This is 402. You're watching MotoVlog number 7. Today we're going to talk about a little bit of a touchy subject, but I feel like I have some opinions about it that I just want to get out there, and hopefully anybody watching this can listen and respect the thoughts, keep an open mind. I mean, we're all entitled to our own opinions. This is simply mine on the subject and on my observations of people that might fall under certain things within the subject. And that subject is the campaign of Black Lives Matter versus the campaign of All Lives Matter. So what do you think? Should it only be Black Lives Matter? Or should it be All Lives Matter? In my personal opinion, I think it should be all lives matter. And while it's unfortunate that it seems like the only demographic that's really getting the media attention of, you know, being hurt or unreasonably attacked by officers or anybody else, is to be that black community. But I'm gonna share some observations with you guys and things I've seen personally or through the interwebs that, you know, might give some insight to why that happens. So, if we're thinking that it's only the black community that gets unreasonably taken advantage of by law enforcement, I recently saw a video online of a white guy, middle-aged, completely normal white guy, who was driving at night with his pregnant wife to the hospital because she was in labor and her water broke, and they were trying to get to the hospital so that they could, you know, have their child. Police officer throws on the lights. The guy's like, "Well, I can't stop. My wife is in labor. I need to get to the hospital." So he calls 911, talks to dispatch, explains the situation, saying, "Hey, we're on our way to the hospital. My wife's water broke. We're having our baby. Will you please let your officer know so that we can get to the hospital? Because my wife needs to be to the hospital." Dispatch told the guy that his best option would be to pull over and explain that to the cop himself. Well, isn't law enforcement's one and sole duty and their oath to their position to protect and serve? What happens is the guy ends up pulling over, and the officer gets out and at gunpoint tells him to get out of the car, lay down face down on the ground. The guy complies, verbally explaining to the officer, "Hey, my wife's in labor, her water broke, she needs to get to the hospital." Well, cop wasn't feeling it. He goes, we'll call an ambulance. He's like, "No, that will take too long. We need to get to the hospital." Well, nope. You're gonna lay face down on the ground at gunpoint. About 4 or 5 more officers show up. And then once the ambulance arrives, and they're finally tending to his wife over 10 minutes later. The officers are joking around on audio and dash cam about, have you tased him yet? Is it too late to tase him? Now, while nothing ended up happening, the guy laid on the ground compliant the whole time. That's what you should do. Even if the officer's in the wrong, you comply to their wishes. Now, you don't have to answer any of their commands verbally. Your best option is to stay quiet. You don't have to answer any law enforcement questions without a lawyer present if you don't want to. But most of the time, you can give quick, simple answers that can't be taken out of context, and you'll be just fine. So now let's switch gears a little bit. Just a few days ago, on July 3rd, we were at our local fireworks show, and it's hosted at a lake where there's a big playground, thousands and thousands of people, mixed cultures, people from every demographic. Well, so our kids, being young, wanted to play on the playground, so we were, and we're standing around the outside edge of the playground where probably close to 100 kids are running around playing perfectly fine, running like crazy kids, playing tag, whatever, being rambunctious. And then there's a group of teenagers that think it's going to be fun to start lighting fireworks right there next to all the young kids. Parents are not having it, and there are law enforcement walking around. So, not only did the fireworks get the police attention, but the parents got the police attention when they realized the fireworks were going off. And so they came up, got the attention of the kid who had lit it. Unfortunately, happened to be a black kid. And they wanted him away from the big group of other kids that were involved so that they could ask him about it, talk to him, see what was really going on. As they're walking away, another kid, same demographic, starts hollering at the cops. This kid's not even involved. But he starts like yelling at them, hollering all crazy sorts of things like, why you gotta take him over there? You're just gonna take him over there into the dark shadow so you can shoot him. Y'all gonna murder him. That's three cops and a kid. Well, no, they're getting him away from the aggressive situation so that they can, you know, talk to him. Say, hey, what you're doing is not smart. So why is it that the majority of a certain demographic is gonna mouth off to somebody whose sole purpose is to protect and serve, and when they try to do their job, that's somehow wrong? And, you know, I don't get it. But once I stop here, we'll get back into the conversation. Let me cool my thoughts down a bit. All right, birthday check deposited. A little bit of a break to, you know, regroup my thoughts. You know, this is a hard subject to talk about. Very hard. But so I'm not saying that the black community deserves the way that they've been treated. But one kind of life philosophy that I've always stood by and think about and try to, you know, let it control the way that I act or I behave is every action has a reaction. If I do something that, one, disturbs somebody's peace, if I break a law, whether that's a traffic law or a city law, or even just a city ordinance, you know, by code, I need to be responsible for the repercussions that might come of that, you know? And if a law enforcement officer shows up, or even anybody of authority, I need to respect that. And to the best of my ability, without like completely surrendering, and you know, know, admitting complete fault if I'm not guilty. I still need to respect the authority and comply to their wishes. For instance, there was a black man couple years ago, I think this first showed up on the interwebs, and you know, he took a video of him getting stopped in traffic. I believe he was speeding. And, you know, so he's a black man. The officer that pulled him over is white. And this guy took a video of the whole confrontation in which the officer asked him for his license and registration. He asked, "Why'd you pull me over?" Calmly. The officer explained. He handed over his documents. And long story short, that was it. I mean, the officer just did his job, and this citizen acted in the way that he was supposed to in this situation. He didn't run his mouth, say anything stupid, and there was nothing that came of it, you know? So, you know, we just need to remember that out of all the crazy things an officer is gonna see during a regular shift, we as citizens need to do our best to help and not make things any worse for them, you know? Like, their job's hard enough as it is. I couldn't imagine being away from my family and getting a phone call or a radio call saying, "Hey, there's gunshots fired. You need to go investigate and find out what's going on and you know, solve the problem. Keep the community safe." And then you show up, and even if there aren't gunshots fired, let's say it's just an altercation, and you show up as that law officer, and people start getting in your face, you go to question one guy, and a group of people show up around you, they are now a threat. So as the public and citizens of this country, yes, while we are free, we need to allow the officers to do their job. And when you become a threat while they're trying to subdue a situation, you are then a problem. And I'm sorry, but if you're gonna act stupid, I will not feel sorry for anything that happens. I'll feel sorry that if, unfortunately, somebody loses a son or a brother or a father prematurely, that's sad. But you are in control of your actions and your behaviors, and you need to act as such and not think that you're above the law. Respect the law, and the law will respect us. Now, don't get me wrong. Doesn't mean I don't break small laws from time to time, maybe even big ones, I don't know. But if I were to get confronted on it, I would respect that officer's authority and let everything play out as calmly as I could. Side note, when there's emergency vehicles on the shoulder, you are required by Nebraska state law to slow down to more than 20 miles an hour under the speed limit or get over one extra lane of traffic, just like I did there. Please keep that in mind. That also goes for tow trucks, ambulances, any type of emergency vehicle that is providing assistance on the side of the road. Thank you. This PSA brought to you by 402. So back to the touchy subject. I think the campaign of only Black Lives Matter is a little selfish, a little self-indulgent, and a little racist on that part. All lives matter. All people of all demographics have been affected by improper law enforcement in the history of our country or the world. You know, stuff happens. Bad people are out there. It's our job to act as upright citizens and respect the authority mean, even if they're wrong in the situation, in the moment, don't be more of a problem. Let them figure out what's going on. Think before you act. Don't act in a way that somebody's gonna react negatively. You know, you don't walk up to a random person in the grocery store and say, "You're freaking stupid, I hate you, I wish you would die." Because that person's gonna all of a sudden get on the defensive and might lash out. Oh, well, no shit. You caused it. Be a solution. Don't be part of the problem. Don't go onto social media typing in all caps saying only one type of life matters and that people are getting hated on solely just because of the color of their skin. That ain't the case. It may be in a very small percentage of situations, but it's not always the case. That's like saying one racist white guy means all white people are racist. That is not the case. So with that, I think I've got what I wanted to share off my chest. And, you know, take it as it is. Listen to it with a grain of salt. I hope that I worded everything well enough, that I wasn't trying to come down on one situation or one specific group of people by any means. You know, things happen, bad things happen, good things happen. We're just citizens in this thing called life. So, let's do what we can to not be part of the problem. So thanks for watching. I think we've got a decent MotoVlog here. And, you know, I'll try to keep it a little lighter next time. But 402, signing out. You know, another example. I wear this right here for my safety. Because, yes, I'm on a sport bike. And if anything happens, if I'm in an accident, if I lay the bike down, the preconceived notion is gonna be that, hey, he's on a sport bike. He was probably speeding. He was probably weaving through traffic. When in reality, if I'm doing that, I'm gonna prove it. But if I'm not, I'm gonna prove that.